Hi everyone, so let's take a look on to the same directory. Here we created a docker compose file. This is the YML. So here service name is node and another service name is a mongo. So mongo is using the existing image, okay, and node is using the docker file which is there, and this is the port mapping 8080. This node image is depending on mongo, and this is the volume mapping for mongodb, okay. And you already aware about the docker file which we already have. The docker file is having basic instruction, working directory, copy the package.json to the app folder, then do the npm install, then expose the 8080 port by running the server, okay. So what we can do, so docker compose is having all these command, docker compose build. So what build will do, build will build all the images, and docker compose up will create the containers once the images are ready. So first we will do the build. So build will build the images from the docker file, but we are using only single docker file. Another is using the mongodb image. So docker compose up when we do, so it will use the existing image because image is already built, right? So it will use the node app, temp node app and temp mongo one. So it has started the mongodb on 27017 and node app on 8080, okay. We can do curl if you want. Right, so we got the hello world from there. This is the hello world message we got. So we actually spin up both two containers from the docker compose file, which is having port mapping, volume mapping. Now my node app wanted to talk to mongodb, right? So the service name here is mongo. So you can access the mongodb URL. You can just replace the local host with the mongo and you will be able to access the mongodb from the node.js container. Later we can also put a single network for both the containers to talk to each other, but here even there is a single same network. While talking to the mongodb, you will not be putting local host because you are inside a container, and container will talk to another container from the container name, service name. From the docker compose we put the service name as mongo. So instead of localhost, you need to put mongo to access the mongodb, okay. So this is how we are running the containers using the docker compose file.